Yo, what's good? It's your boy Bike with another video. Today we're going to be talking about Clip Studio Paint versus Krita using the Tab S7. Now, if you looked at my Clip Studio Paint review, you'll know that I said this about it. And I'm going to tell you something, Clip Studio Paint. If you ever decide to go to subscription base, I'm gone. Pew. Now, I need to find some type of alternative art program that I can use that can substitute for Clip Studio Paint, because I'm not paying that subscription fee. I think a lot of y'all agree with me on the actual subscription fee. So let's get right into the versus battle. So number one, we're gonna look at Krita, and we're gonna break this down into a few categories that we're gonna be judging this on. We're gonna be judging this on price, the UI, user experience, user interface, however you want to say it. And then we're going to be also judging it on the learning curve. How long does it take to actually get used to the program? Is it, you know, is the learning curve steep? Is it easy to learn from? All of that, right? Also, did I actually enjoy drawing on this software? Was it enjoyable? And then the next is going to be, can I actually make commissions with this art software? So we're gonna get right into price. So when we look into price, Krita is free, okay, versus Clip Studio Paint subscription service, right? Which I think the subscription service is depending on which tier you get, but it's as low as about $5 a month or something like that. Now let's go to the UI, user experience. Now, when you look at the user experience for Krita, it looks similar to Clip Studio Paint. It has a lot of different tools that you can actually use. And, you know, that's good, right? That's good. More tools is, you know, usually good. But it is a bit intimidating when you're not actually used to the actual program, because you don't know where to go. You don't know, you know, where's the paint bucket. You don't know where anything is, so you basically have to learn everything over again. And it doesn't seem like it's very, user optimized. We'll just say that, user optimized. And then as I'm drawing with it, testing out the pressure sensitivity, and all of that, I look at the pencil tool. Now, some of the pencil tools look a little bit low res. So, you know, this, the Tab S7 is, it has a 2K screen, right? It has the capability of displaying images at 2K. And so I'm looking at this pencil. I'm like, okay, why is this looking like Nintendo? Like, what am I looking at here? Like, it looks like Atari, like, graphics. Like, real talk. I'm kind of exaggerating, but it's more like 480p or something like that. It's low res. I look at some more pencil tools, and the resolution is perfectly fine. Perfectly fine. So I'm like, okay, what the deal is? What's really going on with this thing? And then another thing I noticed is that instead of using, when you go to your paintbrush tools, right? You go to your paintbrush tools, usually programs, they have like a drawer system where they list out, they have the words like, this is a oil brush, right? This is an oil brush. This is a water brush. Krita doesn't have that. Krita has pictures, right? And pictures, it's okay, right? It's okay for your default brushes, right? Like your paint, your paintbrush, your pencils, your erasers, even your sponges or your stamps or something like that. But when you get into like all of these other brushes, they have Krita has a lot of unique brushes, which is good, but I don't know what it is. I I have to click on them and find out what it is. The pictures all kind of look the same, or they're not really symbolizing what it is that they actually do. So, I mean, you can spend a lot of time picking through the paintbrushes and the pencils and the stencils or whatever, and not really know what it is, what paintbrush you're actually using. So that's, yeah, you know, that's my little quirk on that. And I don't know if it's a way to actually change that. Maybe a way to change it. I don't know, right? But I would consider changing that. And another thing, another nitpick is there is no clear all button. Now in Clip Studio Paint, there is a clear all button. So say I'm drawing and I just started the drawing, or I'm practicing, right? I'm practicing on something and I'm not gonna keep none of this, and I just wanna clear all. On Clip Studio Paint, I just click one button and it clears it all. On Krita, I have to go to File, I have to go to Edit, and then I have to go to Clear All. That's three steps too many, right? Krita, you need one button to clear everything off the layer, right? So that's, you know, I didn't really like that. And then let's go to the learning curve. So the learning curve is, I would say the learning curve is similar to Clip Studio Paint, being the UI setup is similar, right? Besides the pictures, instead of actually having words, I would say it's similar, but a little bit, it's a little bit intimidating at first, even for me. I've used Photoshop, I've used Clip Studio Paint, and it was a bit, it took me a while to kind of like, okay, what is this? What is that? And I still really never got comfortable. So did I actually enjoy my experience on Krita? No, I didn't. Like I stated before, I wasn't really comfortable using it. It's going to be a no for me. It's going to be a no for me. And the thing about Krita is it may be a good application. I've seen plenty of artists make amazing art on it using the actual desktop application. But as far as on the S7, on the Samsung Tab S7, it's going to be a no for me. And you talk about commission potential. Can you potentially do commissions using Krita? I'm going to say, yeah, it has the potential, right? As long as you put in the time to actually start to learn some of the brushes, that's pictures. I mean, I still don't understand that, but long as you spend the time to figure out everything, I would say, yeah, it does have potential that you can potentially do some commissions on. So anyway, for that battle, Krita versus Clip Studio Paint, even though I hate the subscription base, Lord knows I hate it, I'm gonna have to go with Clip Studio Paint this battle. It just wins. The UI is better, it's better optimized. The learning curve, it's too much of a learning curve. I didn't enjoy it at all. Anyway, I hope you got some type of value out of this video today. If you did, hit that like button, smash that subscribe button, and as always, I'll holler at y'all next time. Believe that.